relaxation areas.
Okay.
20th, after 20th, the MHA, Ministry of Home Affairs,
right,
has given guidelines to the various chief ministers,
okay,
on the areas for relaxation, the okay areas of tightening the restrictions, how okay to go about it, abdinsu later.
Uh-huh.
We were discussing about the MSMEs, about the service sector, about the transportation, infrastructure, all that.
Okay.
One area where we need to focus also are the children at home,
right,
particularly the 10th and 12th standard,
right,
where the exams, this came at a very critical time when the exams were going on.
Absolutely.
Particularly central board, a few exams were finished, a few exams are still remaining to do.
Right.
There's a lot of tension. Enna maadhiri aagum appra between state board and central board students or below, you know, the affluent class,
mm-hmm,
they are conducting classes online,
right,
Skype classes and like that.
State
board la that kind of a facility is not there.
Right.
How do you think we should deal with this situation?
See, first of all, I would like to know how equipped are the children to deal with if something is given to them online. Now, the children who are at home now, how much of access do they have to computers? How much are they able to deal with things which come to them online? Are they aware of how to, you know, utilize these equipments? Is that awareness available to these children? Even if we think of giving a solution of going online, because as of now, they cannot leave home. So the only other solution we have left is to give something online. So suppose we do provide them something online, what do you think would be possible by these children?
You see, laptops, the state government has provided to all the students at the 10th mm-hmm standard level.
Right.
So they do have laptops.
Okay.
So it is possible, technically speaking.
And how about the 12th graders who are still waiting to give their this thing? They also have?
Well, 10th standard level, they have got their laptops at 10th
okay
standard.
So they continue
to have that.
Right.
So, but Bhagwan sir, the only question would probably be the availability of the internet for those students, even though the desktop may be available.
Having received the laptops, they would not be keeping it just like that.
Idle, correct.
They would have got their internet.
It's time to explore, to see the opportunity to use that, correct.
Yes. Another thing I would like to suggest here is most of them have a smartphone. So you can tether it to your 4G and you can still work. You don't need an internet
correct
connection.
So
it is not necessary that you need to have an internet line. You can tether it to your phone and you can start utilizing the 4G instead of using it for games or whatever it is.
So what do you think should be done?
I believe that the simplest method here would be to provide laptops to the teachers. The reason why I'm suggesting that is so that they can conduct these programs online with their students, considering the students are used to them. They're used to seeing those teachers. They're used to their method of teaching. They are already stressed out about their 10th and 12th exam. So the easiest way to get them back into the loop would be to let their own teachers teach them. So the simplest solution that I can think of at the moment would be to provide the teachers, even if it was on a temporary basis, with some laptops so that they can start having these Zoom classes with their own students.
Okay, that sounds very, very practical and very correct.
Mm.
I want to toss up to you one observation made by a very well-known educationist in Chennai called Prince
right
Gajendra
right
Babu. Prince Gajendra
right
Babu, he
right
deals with the real lower strata of students.
Okay.
And he has a free school running
mm-hmm
with his own funds
right
for several years. He's pretty
right
well known.
Right.
And he was saying,
uh-huh,
even if you attempt to now
uh-huh
conduct these online classes for the
mm-hmm
state board students,
mm-hmm,
it's a heterogeneous section, these
oh
state
okay
board students.
Okay.
They are not a homogeneous bunch
okay
like the central board.
Right.
There are children who are living with parents. There are children who are sons and daughters of domestic workers.
Right.
There are children who are in orphanages,
mm-hmm,
in government homes. So they will not be able to focus. They do not have the right environment to focus
right
on an online education now. Best
right
is once the lockout is lifted,
right,
give them 15 days of classes at school
right
so that, you know, emotionally and academically you prepare them, and then you expose them to the examination. This is what he says.
All right. He has made a very valid point about the group being a heterogeneous group and that they cannot focus. But my point here is, instead of letting things wait till the lockdown opens and then for us to start, meanwhile, these children have lost complete track of their studies because as it is, they are in an environment where they cannot study. So even looking at the teacher every day can at least motivate them to look at their books.
Excellent.
Right.
That's a very valid point. Yes.
Instead of letting, see, what happens is when they come from this kind of a background, studies is not really something that they easily go to. It's anyway, a teenage child is not someone who goes naturally towards studies. So you're given the freedom and no backup, no teachers telling you anything, nobody telling you have to finish this project. So my point here is maybe 100% of the students may not be able to take advantage of this online program that we're talking about. But many children may still take an advantage about this. And you can still have those 15 days after the school reopens and still train them and still send them for the exams. That doesn't matter. But in the meanwhile, why let them sit idle at home? Why not motivate them and give them the track in which they can at least try and pick up a path?
Engage them.
Yeah. So that they don't lose complete track from their studies. See, if for some reason, let's say if the lockdown continues, then are you trying to tell me that for months on end they would have to wait until the school reopens and then they start preparing? I think that would be very difficult on the children also.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
As a clinical psychologist,
right?
Can you give me a peep into their minds, an average state board 10th standard, 12th standard student?
In which way do you want me to give you? Because they are going to be, like you say, they are a heterogeneous group. So which part of their thing do you want to give me?
I'm talking about an average student, a state board student.
Yes, an average student's attitude towards what? Average student's attitude towards studies.
Towards the lockout at the time of the exams.
I think I think once the average student would be the one who would be nervous. The average performing student. You're talking about academically average performing student, right?
Yeah.
Is that what you mean when you say an average student?
Average academically, average socially, okay. Average socioeconomically.
Such a child would have anxiety, would have fears, and they would be very nervous because they don't know now where they're headed, when they're going to be able to study, whether anyone is going to help them, or they're going to have to manage everything on their own. So there would be a sense of nervousness and fear.
There'll be a lot of stress.
Yes, absolutely. As it is, they are facing a lot of stress because of board exams. And then to suddenly be told that you're not being given your exams and you're not being given any guidance is not something that's easy to deal with.
And so the suggestion that you made about having this online, their own teachers coming online,
right,
will also engage them emotionally.
Absolutely. Because many of them turn to their teachers for emotional support also.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you, Sujata.
It's been
a very valuable input that you have given us.
Oh, thank you so much.
Have a good night.
Thank you for inviting me to talk. Thank you.
So what I find is from a CA students, where I'm a faculty, where in fact they have shown a very good eagerness to learn online because in CA classes, even the online classes, it is not a new thing. They are already equipped to it because when they go for an articleship, etc., they started always already used to listen to the lectures, online lectures. In this particular period, using this technology tool like Zoom, etc., where we are able to give them a feel as if we are in the live classroom, including the solving the problem on the board. There is a whiteboard online which is available. You can use that and give them a feel as if we are in the physical class, and then we can also constantly ask them questions. Even when there are 50 people online, we can still take a very effective session. I think many teachers should explore these opportunity. And one point which Dr. Sujata made sense to me is, though there are a lot of WhatsApp circulations are now coming, like free certification, this, that available from Harvard, this, that, etc., there is nothing like our own teacher coming in front of the screen and then talking to us in this particular tough situation, where it gives a lot of motivation to us instead of staying dull for a long period of time.
Mr. Sundararaman, What you said about CA students will also apply to engineering students, to other professional students also, right?
Definitely, definitely, it applies to also because
it is now the responsibility of the various universities and colleges to respond like this.
Exactly, they should start
thank
moving.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you, sir. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.